As on 31st March 2019, your bank had a total of 9 directors, including one woman director. Except Sri P.Jayarama Bhat, part-time non-executive chairman, and myself, all other directors are independent directors on the board of our bank. This composition of the board is in line with the Banking Regulation Act and Regulation 17 of SEBI, listing obligations and disclosure requirements. Bank's distribution network. During the financial year 2018-19, your bank expanded its footprint by opening 39 new branches across India. Out of these, 9 branches have been opened under financial inclusion initiatives of the bank. As of 31st March 2019, your bank was having 836 branches, 1,540 ATMs and cash recyclers, 325 e-lobby and mini e-lobbies. The bank has opened 2 more regional offices, each at Ahmedabad and Kalaburgi in April 2019 for better administration of the banking affairs, and hence at present your bank has 14 regional offices across India. Digital banking initiatives. Your bank, known for its tech-savvy initiatives, is focusing continuously on further improvement in all its technology-based products to provide sufficient degree of safety coupled with user convenience. The following major digital initiatives were launched by the bank during FY 2018-19. Deposit-only cards for depositing cash in cash recyclers, introduction of centralized CASA account opening process, launching of BHIM application in iOS operating system, all new revamped KBL mobile plus app, green pin facility through ATM and IVR, auto activation of blocked debit cards after 24 hours, and forced pin change in India after overseas pin based ATM or POS transactions abroad. Cash at POS facility at merchant outlets, single sign on SSO facility for DigiLocker services through money click internet banking, discontinuation of physical pin mailers for debit cards, and enabling green pin generation. Our digital banking channels are well accepted by our customers, and about 80% of the transactions have already been migrated to digital platform. About 7 years back, these digital transactions were at the rate of 35%, and your bank now stands almost at par with the new generation banks, who all have 80 to 85% of their transactions being done through the digital channel. These digital banking services provide round-the-clock, seamless banking experience to the customers, and a 24/7 enterprise-level fraud risk management solution, surveillance, is also put in place to effectively counter cyber frauds. Parabanking activities as well as the third-party products. With an aim to provide diversified financial products and all services under one roof to maximize value-added services to the customers, bank provides third-party products such as life insurance, general insurance, mutual funds, demat services, etc. Bank has joined hands with Life Insurance Corporation of India, PNB MetLife India Insurance Company Limited, Universal Sompo General Insurance Company Limited, Bajaj Alliance General Insurance Company Limited, and various mutual fund houses. Further, very recently, that is in April 2019, your bank has entered into an MOU with Bharatiya AXA Life Insurance Company Limited to provide wide range of life insurance products. Information technology. During the year under report, your bank had undertaken a major IT reform by migrating from the existing Pinnacle 7 version of CBS to higher version of Pinnacle 10 in order to gear up for the latest and future technology advancements in banking services for better efficiency, more control and regulatory compliance requirements, and also for meeting challenges of the future. Human resources management. Your bank has been investing continuously on its human resources and attributes greatest importance to employee satisfaction and human resources development activities. Your bank believes in upgrading skills, competencies, and expertise of its employees on a continuous basis based on the LURE concept, that is learning, unlearning and relearning. Apart from traditional methods of trading, your bank has implemented e-learning module under HRMS platform, which enables the staff members to acquire knowledge on the subjects at a convenient location through easy learning techniques without the necessity of attending classroom training. Project failure because bank's transformation initiative journey so far. The last couple of years have been turbulent times for the banking industry. From the crisis of large non-performing assets to emergence of new payment banks to now competition from Google Pay and Amazon Pay, it is very clear that the banking industry is rapidly evolving. And hence, we must also evolve. Shortly after I became MD and CEO in the year 2017, I started working on the need for our bank to keep up with this pace of change. Board also had exclusive meetings to draw the contours of transformation. Accordingly, in our endeavor to become a successful bank of the future and accelerate business growth, your bank initiated a holistic transformation journey called Project KBL Vikas in November 2017. The bank appointed Boston Consulting Group, BCG, a leading global management consulting firm, as its partner in this transformation journey. It has now been 20 months since the program started, and I am very happy to announce that the program has delivered several wins for the bank, while many more are in progress. I want to share some of these with you today. Firstly, KBL Vikas has laid the foundation of a strong sales and marketing culture in our bank. We have deployed a 300 plus members sales team across asset and liability products like loans, salary, savings account and third party products. Regional sales executives have been appointed product wise to lead sales in each of the 14 regions. Sanctioned turnaround, we call it as TAT, for home loan has been reduced from the yesteryear's 30 days to present 7 days. And similar reduction has been seen in MSME loans also by setting up regional loan processing centers. This has led to 26% growth in our home loan portfolio in FY 2019, compared to average 16% growth in the previous year. Commission income from third-party products grew 21% in Q1 FY20 compared to historic growth rate of 8-10%. We have launched new products like savings account for trusts, associations, societies and clubs, and this has brought about rupees 50 crore of new income in just 6 months, new balance in just 6 months. From being a bank that waited for customers to walk into our branches, we are today emerging as a bank that reaches out to its customers through its various channels. Second, our bank has strengthened its risk management infrastructure. We have launched 14 regional collection hubs to systematically monitor and regularize stressed accounts. Collections calling is also done through an outsourced contact center, a first for Karnataka Bank. The entire NPA recovery process has been enhanced through an automated digital tool that enables case-by-case tracking as well as timely action for recovery of that particular impaired asset. Third, our bank has seen a step jump in our digital capabilities. We inaugurated our Digital Center of Excellence, DCOE, in Bengaluru in January this year. Under this initiative, the bank has just launched new home loan and personal loan products where in-principle sanctions are given completely digitally without human intervention, and this is based on BREs, that is Business Rule Engine, and credit scorecard in flat 20 minutes. I would like to again draw your attention the digital transformation that bank has done in this KBM because. To quote one simple example, the simple housing loan, about 3 years back, we were taking about 30 days to give the sanction, and in our version 2, we improved and provided a different the delivery system itself, and thereby improved the TAT to 7 days, and through this digital center of excellence, wherein the loan sanction, that is the housing loans, are now getting sanctioned in flat 20 minutes. This is what I compared with the new generation private sector banks. Even though we are the first generation private sector banks, the digital capability has put Karnataka Bank in a different league, and that is what the greatest achievement during this digital transformation. Last year, the first Digi branch, this housing loan digital journey, whatever now we are doing, we are also introducing this particular concept to the MSME loan journey also. In that digital center of excellence, this journey has already started, and we will be launching this particular MSME digital loan journey within another 3 to 4 months. Last year, the first Digi branch was also launched in Bengaluru, where customers can just walk in and open an account online and generate a debit card within just 15 minutes. This is the power of technology. We are today leveraging several digital tools even in our everyday ways of working. For example, all business leads are now captured in and tracked through KBL Force, an app-based LMS, that is the lead management system. Similarly, review and monitoring is happening through dashboards and daily huddles at each of the branches. Last and perhaps the most important is the transformation of our employees to become agents of change and productively contribute to business. We redesigned our organization structure a few months ago to drive larger focus on strategic areas for the bank and speed up decision making. The new role of Chief Business Officer was created. As a result of this, in addition to the existing role of Chief Operating Officer in the cadre of Chief General Manager, we have initiated a big change in the way we evaluate performance of our people by moving to a digital performance management system that assigns objective business KRAs to each officer and executive. The said PMS will allow us to recognize and reward strong performers while support and develop those who are below par. Further, approval from the regulator has already been received for setting up of a wholly owned subsidiary called KBL Services Limited, and the preparatory works in this regard is underway. KBL Vikas has today become a symbol of change and pride in Karnataka Bank. I have myself led more than 15 town hall meetings across India and able to connect to around more than 70% of my staff personally, so as to onboard more and more of our people onto this change journey. We have had more than 35 steering committees for the project so far, and board is also making critical reviews on quarterly basis. I am pleased to say that the core values of Karnataka Bank have always been kept at the center of this transformation journey. Moreover, all these new initiatives have been delivered by Team KBL in addition to their day-to-day roles and responsibilities, with the active support and involvement of both the recognized unions of Karnataka Bank, without any additional hiring done to support this program. In many of the banks in the past, they have done this type of transformation, but this was driven by external team. But the beauty of Karnataka Bank transformation journey is, this is holistic, this is inclusive, and this transformation journey is driven by the home team. That is the uniqueness of our transformation. I congratulate my team wholeheartedly for their immense contribution to the success of this program, which has been an inclusive and rewarding journey so far. Of course, change is a never-ending journey. In Karnataka Bank, we have just started that. The fruits of this transformation is going to be seen and to be benefited to all the stakeholders in the days to come. But your bank has made a fantastic start. That is what I have to submit to all of you in this 95th annual general meeting. Of course, we are equally focusing more on CSR activities. Your bank has been actively involving in the social welfare of the society under its corporate social responsibility program, which are designed in such a way that it will make a positive impact on a wide range of areas of social life. During the year under report, your bank had sanctioned a sum of ₹870.03 lakh for 227 projects against sanctioned budget of 870.75 lakh. That means almost 100% CSR budget is utilized during the current financial year. The external world has recognized the performance of the bank by conferring many awards and accolades on your bank. I am happy to inform that your bank's performance and service to the society are getting recognized globally by various prestigious institutions in terms of awards and accolades. In the last financial year 2018-19, the bank had bagged a total 21 awards on 12 occasions. Further, your bank's MD and CEO was conferred with the CEO with HR Orientation Award from World HRD Congress. What are our goals for the next financial year? The corporate goal for 2019-20 are a little bit ambitious. Considering the prevailing economic conditions and also growth opportunities, your bank has envisaged a goal of achieving core business turnover of 1,44,000 crores for the year 2019-20, comprising of deposits of 79,500 crores and advances of ₹64,500 crores with a CD ratio of above 80%, thereby envisaging a growth rate of 16.8% in business turnover. It is intended to open 24 new branches so as to reach 860 branches and 75 new e-lobbies, thus taking the total of e-lobbies to 400. Tribute to founders. Your bank has been celebrating its Founders Day every year as a mark of respect to the founding fathers. Accordingly, this year also, your bank celebrated its Founders Day on 18th February 2019, and corporate guru, Pujya Sri Sukhabodhanandaji of Bengaluru Prasanna Trust, graced the occasion and delivered the Founders Day lecture. The lecture was followed by Karnataka classical music concert. Before concluding, on behalf of the bank and on my personal behalf, I place on record our gratitude to the shareholders and customers of the bank for unstinted support and patronage, which has immensely contributed towards the growth of the bank. I thank the Honorable Chairman Sir P.Jayarama Bhat and all the members of the board for ensuring the highest standard of corporate governance and also their encouragement and guidance. The contribution made by the auditors, legal advisors, consultants, correspondents, and of course the channel partners is wholeheartedly acknowledged. I am pleased to record my appreciation for the constructive and proactive role played by both the recognized employees and officers' unions in maintaining cordial industrial relations and the rich contribution made by the dedicated workforce in serving the customers in an efficient way, thus enhancing the customer experience and strengthening the bondage between customers and the bank. I also gratefully acknowledge the continuous guidance and support of the Reserve Bank of India, Indian Banks Association, SEBI, Stock Exchanges, IRDA, and other regulatory and statutory bodies. I also acknowledge with profound gratitude the support of print and visual media. Dear shareholders, the bank is undergoing a transformation change by fully leveraging its technological platform. The changes initiated under transformation exercise have just started yielding the expected results, which will gain momentum in the years to come. Team KBL is committed to strive hard to perform better than its previous best and to reposition the bank as a strong, big, vibrant, relevant and significant entity in the years to come with the highest standards of corporate governance as well as self-discipline. With your continued support, encouragement and patronage, I am confident that your bank will scale further heights in value creation for the society at large by further strengthening its fundamentals and by keeping intact its core value and identity. Thank you one and all for your gracious presence.
Thank you.